Experiment, we are going to find speed and torque analysis of epicyclic gear train to determine the holding torque of epicyclic gear train arrangement. Okay. The specification required for this apparatus is radius of output breakdown, that is R2, 0.09 meter, then radius of epicyclic gear train body, that is R3, 0.06 meter. So these are the specification of our apparatus. Let's see the observations we are going to conduct in this experiment. So this is the in terminal form, we are going to conduct observation. First of all, we are going to find voltage, current at no load condition. Then RPM, input RPM and output RPM, that is N1 and N2 at no load condition. And then we are going to find the spring balance. This we are going to find the forces at the no load condition. In second reading, we are going to apply a certain kg of load on the brake drum. Then we are going to find all these values. Okay. Let's see the formula for the holding torque. The formula for the holding torque is F3, that is the force at the epicyclic gear train body multiplied by the radius of the epicyclic gear train body. Let's go to the experiment. This is epicyclic gear train apparatus. This is control unit where you can see the current, voltage, speed, and this is the control unit for the RPM or speed of the motor. So this is the motor which is connected to the epicyclic gear train body, which is having a sensor in between motor and epicyclic body, which measures the speed of this epicyclic body. Then this is the spring balance. This is nothing but the spring balance to apply or to measure the forces on the epicyclic body. This blue color is the brake drum where we are going to apply brake. In the sense, we are going to apply load on this brake drum. Here there is another spring balance where it gives the measures of which or what kind of load we are going to apply on the brake drum. Let's start the experiment. To start the experiment, we are going to start the switch on control unit. So you can easily see here the control panel. Let's give the RPM or rotate the motor. At initial stage, for example, we are taking the RPM as 310 RPM at epicyclic gear train, where there is no load applied on the brake drum. So we can see current here, current is 1 ampere and voltage is 2526 voltage is there. Okay, and the RPM shown here is of this epicyclic gear train body. So this is about the low load condition. Let's apply a certain load on the brake drum. So here I am going to apply load of 2 kg, which is showing on here spring balance. So I am applying load of 2 kg. So RPM is automatically reducing. You can easily see here the RPM is automatically reducing. With that, current requirement is increasing as the load applied on the brake drum. So this we are going to find how much holding torque applied on this epicyclic gear train. For that, for holding torque, we require the force at this epicyclic gear train that we can find on the spring balance. So here, the holding torque force required is 2 kg. So we are going to convert this force into the load. How we are going to convert that we will find. So let's go to the calculation. As experiment conducted, the observation in the observation table, we are having the readings for the load condition. That is 2 kg of load we have applied on the brake drum. So for 2 kg, the voltage we have found is 50, then current is 1 ampere, then input RPM. The input RPM is at epicyclic body, that is 521 RPM. Then output RPM at brake drum is 90. Then this is the force, that is load multiplied, that is kg multiplied by 9.81, we will get the load in Newton. So this is the spring balance at epicyclic body and spring balance at the drum. Okay. Then let's see the how we are going to find the holding torque. Holding torque we are going to find F3, the load force at epicyclic body, that is 39.24, and the R3, that is radius of epicyclic body, that is 0.06 meter. So we will get the answer of holding torque 0.235 Newton meter. In same manner, for different load condition we are having the different observations. So we can find different load condition, different holding torque. Okay, thank you.